Hello everyone, my name is Vikal Jain and today I am going to show you how to track your due dates. So here is the start date of the project and here is the due date. So today date is this, so you can see my due date has already expired, but about this case my due date is going to come. So 205 days are pending for this due date. What we are going to do in this video, we are going to find out total number of entries, how many dates has already expired, how many dates are upcoming in next 30 days, and the last we are going to cover after 30 days how many dates are approaching. So let's begin. So let's find out the total number of entries equal count. So I am selecting my data, lock it. So if your data is dynamic, you may convert this into a table, so it will update automatically. Now we are going to find out the expired due date. For this we are going to use sum product. Select your data like this. Now lock it. Now if this difference would be greater than 0, it means your date has already expired. So it will produce me some true and falses. If I will press F9 key on my keyboard, so you can see true, since the date is expired. Here false, since my date is not expired till yet. Control Z. Now I am putting a parenthesis. Now I am multiplying this 1. If I will multiply any true and false with number 1, so true multiplied by 1 would be equal to 1 and false multiplied by 1 equal to 0. So close the parentheses and enter. So 64 entries has already expired. It means my 64 project date has already gone. So now we are going to find out the due dates which are approaching in next 30 days. For this we need to again use the sum product. I am cheating here. I am just copying the sum product in edit mode like this. Now here I am going to paste it. Instead of greater than sign, I am using less than symbol, and I am copying this. Now I need to put a condition once again. So since we are tracking 30 days, so here we can put greater than and minus 30. Why we are using minus 30? Since negative here is saying due date is still going to come, it is not expired. That's why I am using minus sign here, and again multiply by 1. So what it will done, it will multiply 1 into 1, provide me 1. Then we are going to make a sum. So enter. 4 dates are going to approach in next 30 days. Again I am cheating here, copying this for 30 days. I need to use less than symbol, minus 30, and here enter. So 29 dates is going to approach after 30 days. So here it is 33. So the total is 97. It means my calculation is correct. Now we are going to apply conditional formatting here. So I am selecting my data, conditional formatting. Here we are going to come in new rule. Now we are going to apply the same thing in conditional formatting. So use the formula equals, if this is greater than 0, then due date has already expired. I am using relative reference. Press F4 key to remove the dollar. Format. For expiry date I am using red color, and font as a white. Okay. So all the due dates with positive number has already expired. Now what about next 30 days? So again, I am putting a conditional formatting. Conditional formatting, new rule, user formula equals. So now here we are going to use AND function. AND has a ability to provide me two logical conditions. So if this is a greater than 0, sorry, if this is a less than 0 and greater than minus 30. So again, I am removing this dollar format. For next 30 days, I am using yellow color, yellow. Okay. Now you can filter out those transactions. Filter by color and yellow. You can see only 4 entries are there, which are upcoming in next 30 days. Now at the last, we are going to put a conditional formatting on those entries which are not going to approach in next 30 days. So again, I'm not selecting the header. Conditional formatting, new rule, user formula, and again I'm using this. Now this would be less than minus 30, then format. For this I am using green sign. Okay. I have not removed my dollar symbol here. Okay. Now green means my date is not approaching in next 30 days. Yellow means my date is approaching in next 30 days, and red means my date has gone. Now I can't do nothing in these projects. So this is the tracking of due dates. So keep enjoying and keep learning.